Hey, good morning. Welcome to Elmbrook. Let's all stand together.
Oh, Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, thy thy power throughout the universe is great. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to me. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul,
Christians all over the world today celebrating the triumphal entry of Jesus into Jerusalem some 2,000 years ago. We join together with the song that is coming from the church around the world today. Something happened this week that kind of inspired me in the context of Palm Sunday. On Thursday night, Jason and I brought two of our kids to our rehearsal here at the church, and our boys who are 6 and 8 were with us. And after the rehearsal, Todd Scott, who many of you know, Todd's been on staff for 27 years, he's our sound engineer. Well, after rehearsal, he took our boys and kind of showed them a lot of the behind-the-scenes stuff, some of the technical gear and stuff, and they were just fascinated, and they loved it. They had a great time. And in the car ride on the way home, My 8-year-old says something really interesting on the drive. Out of nowhere, he goes, "You know what, Dad?" He goes, "If anybody's going to heaven, it's Mr. Todd, because he's so nice." And I said, "Really?" And he said, "Oh, yeah, times 10, you know?" And it was this great moment, you know, because he was moved by Todd's generosity and time that he spent with him. And I will tell you that in that moment, I was tempted to correct his theology, right? Because, of course, we don't get to go to heaven because we're nice, right? It's because of what Christ has done for us. But I didn't correct his theology in that minute. I thought, I'll just let him live in that revelation for now. And when the time is right, he'll get it, right? I thought about Jesus on Palm Sunday. Because remember, he enters into the city of Jerusalem. Remember what they were crying out? They were crying out, "Hosanna! Hosanna!" Which literally meant, like, deliver us, save us, God. And in their limited understanding, they thought that salvation was going to look like Jesus kicking out the Romans, right? They had limited understanding. And watch this. On that day when they were worshiping, Jesus didn't correct them. I think Jesus maybe would have thought, they'll get it eventually when the time is right. Now, I don't know where you are in your understanding of what God's salvation looks like. Maybe you've been following Jesus for decades and you have a great understanding of it. Or maybe you're here this morning and you don't even understand anything about God's love and salvation grace. Wherever you are, if you would be willing today to cry out like those of Palm Sunday thousands of years ago and just say, "Hosanna, Jesus, save us, deliver us." I think that his Spirit, God's Spirit, will honor your request and bring you further in your understanding. Is anybody with me on that? So before we sing again, if you would maybe lift your eyes to heaven or bow your head, whatever would be an attitude of prayer for you. And would you say, "Jesus, hear my song. Hear my song when I cry out to you, Hosanna. Grow me in my understanding of you and in my love for you." And Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Lift that up. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
God. Thank you, God, for your presence among us. Lord, your word says when two or three gather in one place, you are in our midst. We welcome you, God. We thank you, you are here to change us and draw us near. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath.
Every breath, every dream, every aspiration, every goal, our pursuits, all that we are. We present ourselves to you as living sacrifices. Our Redeemer, our Savior, our Deliverer. In Jesus' name, and everyone together said, amen. Amen. Before you're seated this morning, take a moment and greet some folks around you, and then you may be seated.
Well, good morning and welcome to Elmbrook Church.